Hey everyone, last weekend the East China's regional selection competition in Hangzhou took place and some crazy scores happened. We got 260 points driver, 220 auton, and most importantly, three new world records for teamwork. In qualifications, a 370 point match happened as well as a 401 point match, but we want to focus on the finals match with 390 points because we can see the robots very clearly in this match. And today we're actually joined by a guest speaker from Quasar.
Hi, I'm from Team 3722U in the North Florida region.
All right, thanks for joining us today, and make sure you guys sub to his channel linked in the description. So if we start this match, we can see that these two robots are very similar to the robots that we have seen earlier with 180, and they're basically doing the same route as the 359 point. They're both just stacking. And we can see that the blue robot over here is doing that 110 point stack. And it's only been like 18 seconds into the match and they've already done this 110 point stack. So they're moving really, really fast. And we can learn a bit about how they do that in the future. And we can see that that 91 point stack there is finished. And now both teams are just focusing on these normal stacks here. And there's that three colored stack that we've seen. And here we can actually see that both of these starting pins are fully cleared. So now they're basically just finishing up in the last few seconds and they drop those stacks over here into the triangle goals. And also they do manage to get both of those starting pins off, which does give them a bigger point boost. So now I'm going to pass it on to our guest speaker to talk a bit about these robots.
Okay, so basically one of the reasons that they're able to move super fast and like clear these routes really quickly is because of their drivetrain. So their drivetrain, I can't really tell what ratio they have, but it's probably 2-to-1 or possibly higher, like a 2.5-to-1. Most likely two motor drive. One of the special things about their drivetrain is that they're able to drive over the loading zone. So basically they're able to drive over a loading zone, which is really convenient because all they need to do is touch the pin and like just go back and score it and just drive forward. So they're able to drop the stack straight into a triangle. Then they can just back up and just get that stack. Okay, so another really important part of the robot is their retractable aligners. Basically, you can see that their aligners retract when they push against the standoff. That's really different from what XG does, and that saves them an extra pneumatic slot for another mechanism. Okay, now for another important part for the robot, which is their beam aligners. Their beam aligners, basically, as you can see, opposed from other robots, most robots, that just stick out of the robot. So basically, this time, their aligners are attached to their beam clamp. And what happens here is that when they raise it up, when they back up into the goal, they're not afraid of it, like knocking the other stack out of the other zone. We saw that in the previous world record match of 359 points, where XG pushed out the stack from the actual center zone, and Samstar had to deviate from the route to fix that. So we fixed the issue here.
Yeah, and I think, of course, as I talked about in these previous videos, this center goal right here is a very big error point for a lot of teams because the pins have to be perfectly inside. And I think this could just add to the consistency of the match and save a lot of time.
Yeah, for sure. Okay, another big part of their robot is their claws. As you can see here, it is a variation of a 4x8 claw, which can hold a double stack. So holding a double stack and scoring a double stack on the tile is really important because it allows you to save like a couple seconds so you can like get yourself in position for the next pin. This arm, as you can see here, is also hinged, which is basically the norm now for a lot of robots. Another part for this arm is that it's band assisted, meaning that they can pick up and lower the pins really quickly and they have like zero to no struggle when they're scoring tile. This also allows for the consistency of like regular stacking as well, because sometimes the motors have slack in it, which is like really bad for 180 mechs because they require a lot of consistency. Okay, so one of the biggest parts of this robot, which make it really unique opposed to other robots, is this center mechanism here. I call it the back tech, the beam and arm coupling tech, when we raise the 4-bar up, it forces the arm to go at a specific height. You can see this in the video here. You see when they score the triangle goal, their 4-bar raises up and lifts their claw to a perfect height. That's really important because it offers a lot of consistency when we're trying to score a triangle goal. Like if you just tell it to like rotate to for a specific angle, it might not always reach that angle. Also, another reason the back tech is really unique is that if your claw is like really hinged and at that height, it's going to make the stack fall over when it drops it. This like pushes on the clamp to make it perfectly horizontal. I'm pretty sure they got this tech from Stemstar, which they use on their second gen robot.
All right. Thank you for that analysis. I think the back tech is probably one of the most like interesting things that we've seen from this competition. And I do think that this is just going to pretty much be the changes of the robots that we've seen as the season goes on, because 180 is pretty much already mostly tuned well. I mean, actually, these clamps, these aligners, these claws, they've already made the 180 so good. This is just an example of like the many improvements to the 180 that maybe like you might not be able to think of directly. And another thing you might have noticed as we watched the video is that their stacking on the beam is very smooth, which a lot of teams, especially in our Discord server, have had some issues with. And the main reason why their scoring is so smooth is that we can actually see how high their beam is compared to the ground. So their lift does have a macro that lifts up the beam a lot. And you can even see the shadow on that. And when the pin comes around, like, there's no nesting issues and all of it goes in perfectly. And another part of their strategy, which is kind of more like leaning to the time, is that they flip these pins, not one by one, but all at once, which is pretty different to what we've seen in a lot of other competitions. And this has pretty much been a really big debate. Like, is it faster to do one at a time or two at a time? And, you know, think that it really depends on your robot, like your flipping speed, your consistency of flipping and all of that, as well as your route. But they seem to both be doing two at once, so we may start to see more about that. So yeah, that's basically all that we want to cover. If you guys want to see this video for yourself in full, you can go into the link down in the description. Huge thanks to Super Robin from Stemstar for posting this video on Bilibili. And again, this was the champion of the event, so 390 points, very high scoring, and I think that we're gonna be starting to see like above 400 points very consistently in China, especially in their nationals, which is only just 1 month away. So make sure to stay tuned on our channel because we'll be covering every single run. So if you guys think that this analysis has helped you or your team, please consider liking and subscribing. And if you want to see the pictures that we've shown in this video, make sure to join our Discord in the description. But that's going to be all for today. See you guys next time. Check my pants, they say true man. They say true man. Blue pants, blue pants, blue pants.